Back at the end of the 20th century, long before the credit crunch or gold-plated gasoline, came the camcorder. Up until then, most of us who had been home cinema fans for many years had had to put up with dim, flickery films shot on silent 8mm celluloid with a total running time of 4 minutes per reel. To begin with, as with all new technology, camcorder prices were expensive, but as time went by, these dropped to affordable levels. At this point, millions of us bought these great new gadgets, and with a nod towards Hitchcock and DeMille, began producing such original titles as Baby on the Lawn, Uncle Fred Getting Drunk at Our Wedding, and the unforgettable Our Dog Chasing Its Tail. As memorable as many of these titles are, the important fact was that these small, inexpensive gadgets could produce results that until recent years had cost millions and needed a studio and shooting crew to enact. This in turn spawned a whole new genre of television programmes such as holiday bloopers and family outtakes. Then, just as the fun was really taking off, some bright spark in an industrial estate invented digital technology. This was good in one way, as it allowed much more control over the finished video via new software that came onto the market. But what about all our old videotapes that nestled next to the now redundant analogue camera in the top of your wardrobe? These cinematic gems could have been lost to humanity. With a digital camcorder, one has the choice of downloading directly onto a computer via either a USB terminal or preferably a firewire. Either way, the digital signals feed directly into your chosen editing software for easy titling plus good audio control. It also produces the chapters that we drag and drop onto our timeline. However, many of us cannot do this with our old analogue equipment. This video shows how it can be done. This is a list of hardware and software required. First of all, the original analogue camcorder that your old films were shot on. The original film cassettes. The wire that connects your camcorder to your DVD recorder. The charger for your old camcorder. A DVD recorder, blank DVD discs, a computer with sufficient memory to handle filmmaking, which must be equipped with a DVD disc drive, software to convert the information from the data on the DVD to files acceptable to your film editing software. I use Roxio Easy Media Creator 9, which I will use to illustrate the process. But there are many more on the market. You must check your editing software to find out the files that it will accept. I also use Windows Movie Maker for editing, and therefore will show how to create WMV files for this system. Other software may use other types of files. During the procedure to convert our tapes, I will mention several items of software and hardware. All of these are registered trademarks owned by the companies involved. I am not endorsing these products as being any better or worse than others, but merely using them to illustrate the narrative of my system. If your old analogue camera has stood idle for a number of years, the chances are that the batteries are unserviceable. With my camera, this is not a problem, as I can use it with the charger in place. This is normally the case with no cameras, but always check your handbook or with a manufacturer before proceeding. Most manufacturers recommend running this way when downloading, but you must make sure that this is the safe thing to do with your equipment. The first part of the procedure is to make a DVD of your old film. If the whole tape is taken up with family memories, then there will be 60 minutes of action. If so, then record the whole thing on a single disc in one go. Use the highest quality setting commensurate with the length of film, i.e. SP. My old camera is monaural, therefore there are only two output connections that go into the DVD recorder. One for sound, one for vision. If yours has stereo sound, then you will have three. Record your film onto a DVD disc and then finalise it so it can be read by your computer disk drive. Next, boot up your computer and install the disc into the disk drive according to the manufacturer's instructions. Next, click on your Media Creator or Converter software. On the left-hand drop-down menu, click on Video. Then, on the drop-down menu, click on Capture Video. On the next screen, click on the drop-down, select a device or source to import from. This will reveal the disk drive in use, mine being D. Click on the drop-down menu, Capture Settings, and choose WMV. That's if you're actually using the same editing suite that I'm using. Then choose Save File to See Documents and Settings Video TS, which is already set onto. Under Rename Files, write the file title such as, in this particular case, it's a film that I took on the Isle of Wight, so I'm going to name it IOW Film. Now this is important. Click on the movie thumbnail here. Once this is lit up, the Import Now command can be activated here on the right hand lower corner of this screen. We have now started the progress of converting the DVD to WMV files. And progress will be shown here, passing along to the end. You'll notice I've ticked this dialog box. Close this dialog box when finished successfully, so we'll know when the whole thing is finished. This can in fact take some time. Now that we've converted our files from the DVD disc to WMV files, we can now go on to our movie editing suite, which in this case is Windows Movie Maker, and we can now import those files by clicking on Import Video, and there on our Video TS is the IOW film, which we named from that. So we light that up and import it. If we crank down to the bottom, we can see how many chapters have been created. This is a fairly long film, and at the bottom you can see that we've created 141 different chapters. From here, we can pull the chapters down, drop them onto the timeline, and create our film.